this is a movie that you can't really put it in a category. And I think a lot about when people ask me, well, what's the movie? And I think a lot about, you know, what can I compare it to? And, you know, it's funny because I'll start and say, well, it's like kind of like 300 meets Star Wars a little bit, meets Avatar, meets, you know, Alexander. And you really realize there's not really a definition for it. And, you know, it's certainly not a sword and sandals movie. It's a movie we've never seen. And I almost feel like it would be like someone saying, you know, what's Star Wars before Star Wars ever came out? And, you know, I feel like, you know, this movie is something that is different and as a genre in and of itself. What Tarsem does, unlike anybody that I've ever seen, is he doesn't just direct a movie. He directs every speck of a movie. You know, he's a brilliant, not just director, but artistic mind. And when he does a scene, you know, this is a very, obviously a big commercial epic story, you know, which is important, but he treats it not like, you know, just, oh, this is just a big action scene, let's go shoot it with a lot of action. He treats it like, what is in every frame of every scene? You know, I mean, he knew before we even finished the script what color sandals every person had on, what color cape they were going to wear, what kind of sword, what the shape was, you know, the direction that his head is going to turn, you know, every second of every scene. And so it's something that is it's a movie within a movie. And when you watch this, I mean, all I can say is it's going to be the most epic ride, and it's also going to be the most beautiful ride. And that's something that only a visionary can put together. He's so talented and so mesmerizing. He's perfect for Theseus, you know, this character that you know, he's kind of part of all of us. You know, on the other end of the spectrum, you have Mickey Rourke, who's just this force to be reckoned with that, you know, plays King Hyperion, our bad guy. And, you know, it's just, the two of them together, it's like really good versus evil, and just, you know, kind of this purity that Henry carries with this just insane, you know, anger and, you know, just rage that Mickey can play so well. And then you have everything in between from, you know, obviously Frida Pinto and Stephen Dorff, and, you know, just our cast honestly came together in such an amazing way. I mean, it's a dream cast. The story really is, forget that it takes place, you know, in ancient times. It really is a present day story of, you know, the struggle that every one of us goes through. And, you know, here's a boy who thinks he's destined for much more, but he's really the outcast in society, and, you know, the beggar and the peasant. And, you know, he effectively ends up, you know, kind of training quietly this inner, not just physical force, but also spiritual, mental force. And, you know, he becomes a really a force to be reckoned with that we don't quite, you know, he doesn't quite know. He's just doing it and living his life and living his own kind of existence aside from everybody else. And then one day he finds out, you know, that he is destined for so much more, that he's the savior of the world effectively. And we have put together a team of the top choreographers, trainers, stunt fighters, everything from, you know, swordsmen to karate experts, in a way that, I mean, these are going to be wars and stunt scenes and fights like no one has ever seen. I mean, we've literally had the fights choreographed for 6 months in a way that, like, just to make them, I don't know what the word to use, but as badass as possible. I mean, this is going to be an ass-kicking movie.